What's up, guys? It's your boy Mike Diamonds, and welcome to the full day of eating. Now, if you guys have been with me following my journey, I've been dieting down for 10 weeks, trying to lose all the body fat that I can to get into shape for the summer. There's so many disclaimers I need to put out in the video, so sit back, relax, and enjoy. Guys, I tend to believe that I have the worst metabolism around, and it takes a lot of hard work for me to lose the belly fat. But I did promise you guys, you've been following my journey, that every time my diet and my macronutrients changed, I would give you guys every single update. And this one is probably the last one and the most drastic one. Before we dive into the diet that got me shredded, before I reveal that, there's so many disclaimers we have to go over. So let's quickly rerun all the macros that I've had from the beginning of my diet. So at the beginning of my diet in week one, I was at 2,800 calories. I moved into week two with exactly 2,668 calories. My calories in week three were dropped to 2,380. And between week 5 and 6, they were dropped to exactly 2,300. In week 6 to 7, they were dropped to 2,125. And in week 8, they were dropped to 2,000 calories exactly. And at this particular point is where I decided to do something that is very different, and that is what my secret has been. From week 8 onwards, I changed my diet that would allow me to go from being lean or skinny fat to shred it. That protocol was changed, and what I'm particularly doing is a thing called calorie cycling, or many of you guys know it, carb cycling. And today I'm gonna be showing you guys the high calorie day, or the high carb day, of my particular diet. Day two, I'll show you guys what my low calorie day is. So sit back, relax, and enjoy this comprehensive full day of eating. Yeah. Now guys, before we dive into the food that's right behind me here, there's a few disclaimers that I have to give you guys. I've been dieting for about 10 weeks now, and the diet right behind me is testament that it works. It's sustainable, it has been cheap for me on a student budget, but also it requires a lot of hard work. But before we dive into the foods behind me, let's dive into the disclaimers. Number one, if you're new to dieting and you have no idea this is the first video you're ever watching, I suggest you don't eat the calories that are this low. I suggest you start at high calories the same way I did, and over the weeks you gradually drop your calories so your body can, one, adjust to the calories, and two, for you to lose fat accordingly and gradually. The idea is also that you don't want to lose all that weight and then binge eat after you've finished dieting. What you wanted to do is for it to be sustainable. Number two, the dieting protocol that I use is called intermittent fasting. What that basically is, in my 24-hour day, I fast for a particular 16 hours and I eat within an 8-hour window period. Number three is that for me to be able to manage this diet, which is particularly low calories for me, what I do is that I drink a lot of water, a lot of mineral water, and I also drink coffee. That allows me to regulate my appetite and suppress my appetite a little bit with the coffee. But now that that's done, let's dive into the calories for my high calorie day, and I'll show you all the foods I'm about to eat. So this video will span over 2 days. Today is my high calorie day. Let's run you through the macros quickly. So today's my high calorie day, I'll be eating exactly 2,100 calories. That is 193 grams of protein, 250 grams of carbs, and 37 grams of fat. What you guys should note here is how high my carbs are. And guys, if you guys can do me the biggest favor, is drop the video a huge thumbs up right now so you guys don't forget. I think that the video will be extremely beneficial to anybody who doesn't know how to diet, and someone who can't stay on track with their diet. The video is going to be extremely well explained. We'll show you how I prepare all the foods, and most of all, it'll be entertaining. So hit that thumbs up for your boy, and let me show you all my groceries here right quick. Let's dive into my grocery list that I'm going to use over the next 2 days. I've separated everything according to my protein sources, my carbohydrate sources, and my fat sources. Starting off with proteins, my protein sources are lean ground beef, chicken breasts, and chicken schnitzels. I also like getting the egg whites from the eggs. And also another great part is I love adding beans. Although it is predominantly carbohydrates, it has a great protein profile. Going on into my carbohydrates, my main source of carbs is rice, guys. Now, I bought these Uncle Ben's basmati rices just for this video in the UK when I was there last week. But what is also perfectly fine, guys, is basmati rice. This is also fine for your diet, and this is what I use in general. Now, moving on into the... Now moving on in terms of vegetables, I love getting pumpkin, guys. And this bag alone is 100 calories. So pumpkin is extremely essential on my low carbohydrate days. Moving on, guys, I have a serving of spinach and a serving of lettuce. This allows me to volumize my food. Another great micronutrient is asparagus. This helps you drop your water weight as it is an awesome diuretic. So a lot of old school bodybuilders and analogies today still use asparagus. Moving on, guys, to make this diet sustainable, I love my Oreos. I know a lot of you guys were asking, Mike, where are the Oreos? Here they are. Although these are the Oreo Thins because they're half in the amount of calories, this helps me sustain my diet. I also have 90 calorie fitness bars. And guys, you also need a serving of micronutrients in terms of fruits. So I have strawberries. Why strawberries? Because they're lower in carbohydrates compared to a lot of the other ones. And condiments, I like using Cholula hot sauce and Frank's Red Hot. And what you're seeing here is barbecue spice. Guys, your food does not have to be boring. And here, guys, is a great general overview of all the foods that I have. And that's meal number one. I will give myself a 10 out of 10 for that presentation. But on a serious note, a lot of guys always ask me, Mike, when should I eat these meals? In reality, it doesn't matter as long as you eat it within the 24 hours. However, I do advise you after, when you decide to break your fast, have meal number one at 2 p.m. in the afternoon. Why? The chicken schnitzel is great for a little bit of carbs and the protein, and you're gonna be chugging water throughout the day. So asparagus is gonna help you maintain and regulate that water weight throughout the day. So this is meal number one. I'll catch you guys for meal number two. And here we have meal number two. I advise to have this post-workout for two reasons. Why? You're gonna be very, very hungry. And before you dive into your main meal, I advise to have a chicken salad so you can feel full before you dive into your main meal. And this is also gonna help you with your micronutrients. So I'll catch you guys for meal three. My last main meal, which I would practically eat at 10 p.m. at the end of my fast, is all this glory. That is the main meal, but let me show you guys what my entire full day of eating on my high calorie day looks like. This, guys, is all my main meals. So for the first meal at 2 p.m. it is the one chicken schnitzel along with a handful of asparaguses. The second meal right post workout, which will be at around 7 p.m. after your workout, is the chicken salad, which is absolutely huge bowl of salad that contains lettuce, spinach, and tomatoes. And the last meal, which you can really divide into two, guys, that covers my whole plate, comes around 10 p.m. To finish off my macros, one packet of Oreo Thins. So I have one packet of Oreo Thins today. We'll see you guys tomorrow. This is one of my secret weapons. Like I said, I've talked about it before. I make iced coffee. Number one, you just make coffee regularly as you'd normally do, and I use sweetener to sweeten up the drink. And then I pour it into ice, and I put as much ice as I can into it, and it makes it such a long beverage. And this helps me a lot with the appetite. You'll probably catch me later tonight for meal number one on my low calorie day, but it's this that I have. And then I also chug mineral water, and it feels like I'm drinking a fizzy drink. But these are a little bit of the tricks that I use to survive on a low calorie day. I'll catch you guys for meal one. So welcome to day two of my macros, guys. So what you guys just saw me do, I had a coffee in the morning and I've been chugging my water and I went to training. I still feel fine. However, this is the day that I feel on my lowest because I'm on such low calories. Before I read to you guys what my calories are, I do not advise this for anyone, but to get shredded, to get to that low single digit body fat, for a natural bodybuilder, sometimes you need to be able to take your calories that low. And also the fact that I've been dieting in a small constrained time, I've had to go pretty aggressive. But these are my calories for today. Today I'm eating exactly 1,533 calories. That gives me 200 grams of protein, 70 grams of carbs, and 50 grams of fat. The name of the game is to be able to stretch out those amount of calories as much as you can. And what that means is you're going to have to minimizing. So this particular part is where you guys are gonna see all my little tips and tricks to make my food feel like it's 3,000 calories. So let's kick it off with meal number one. So here we go, guys, meal number one in all its glory. Here we have exactly 345 grams of chicken breast along with the lettuce that I don't count because it's not worth counting that much of calories. It won't make a huge difference, but this is my post-workout meal. In New York, I'm Millie Rock, had it in my socks, running from an op, and I shoot at op, and I'm on the block, and I'm on the block. In New York, I'm Millie Rock, hiding in my sock, hiding in my sock, selling every rock. In New York, I'm Millie Rock, hiding in my sock. Number two in all its glory, guys. Look at that. That is a lot of food. Believe it or not, guys, the last meal is two hard-boiled eggs. Why? Because this contains a good amount of protein and allows me to hit my fats on a lower carb day. And this contains no carbohydrates as well. Let me show you guys in total what 1,533 calories look like. So this is my entire full day of eating, guys. A lot of people like to see what 1,533 calories look like, but here you go. So you have the salad over there, you have the eggs to sleep off with, you have your main meal there, which is the ground beef, and then you mix it that with the spinach. And you guys know I like to have it fun, so I have a 90 calorie fitness bar for my sweet tooth. But that is my entire meal for my low carb day. As you guys can see, there's no big heavy carbs in here. The pumpkin volumized the food. I also have the lettuce in there to continue volumizing my chicken breast. But let me sign off. I hope you guys really enjoyed this full day of eating. I hope it had all the information that you wanted, and I did put a lot of effort into it. So for your boy, leave the video a huge thumbs up. Also, if you're new to the channel, please do subscribe to the family. This is my button right here to subscribe to the channel. And if you haven't seen the last video, this is the last video over here. But I'll see you guys in the next one. Peace.